Hey there, I'm Mike, and today I'm going to show you how to fix the SSL version interference error on Chrome. Did you just try to visit a website in Chrome only to be met with a message saying, error SSL version interference? Web browsers and servers use SSL TLS to encrypt data. If the browser and server aren't using compatible versions of SSL TLS, or if something is interfering with the connection, you might see this message. In this video, we're going to cover some ways that can help you fix the SSL version interference error. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there'll be links to more resources in the video's description below. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, let's get this thing fixed. Most of these tactics apply whether you're visiting someone else's website or your own website. However, the last troubleshooting solution specifically applies to webmasters experiencing this issue. So you'll definitely want to pay attention to that solution if you're working on your own website. To improve performance, Chrome will store certain website files and data on your local computer. This is called cache data. In some situations, this cache data can trigger errors if it's out of date, including the error SSL version interference error. To rule this out, you want to clear the Chrome browser cache. Here's how. Enter Chrome settings, clear browser data in your browser address bar. Set the time range equal to all time. Check the box for cached images and files, and leave the other box unchecked. Click the Clear Data button. In order to look up the IP address behind a domain name, Chrome uses the domain name system. To improve efficiency, your computer will cache these results. If something goes wrong in the DNS cache, this can trigger errors like error SSL version interference. To rule out any issues here, you can flush or clear the DNS cache. Here's how to flush the DNS cache on Windows. Open command prompt. A fast way to do this is to press Window plus R and then type CMD and then hit enter. Type ipconfig/flushdns and hit enter. To learn how to flush the cache on other platforms, including macOS, check out the resource that we've linked below. In some cases, you might see this error if your Chrome browser doesn't support the latest TLS versions, but the website is configured to only use the most recent version of TLS. This isn't likely to be the cause if you update Chrome regularly, but it could happen if you're using a very old version of Chrome. To rule this out, make sure that you're using the latest version of Chrome. Here's how. Enter Chrome settings/help into your browser address bar. Chrome will check for updates and automatically apply them if found. Click the relaunch button to apply the update and relaunch the browser. Every SSL certificate has a validity period. That is, it expires on a certain date and time. If your computer's date and time settings are wrong, Chrome might mistakenly think that the website's SSL certificate has already expired, even though it's still valid based on the correct time and date. To rule this out, make sure that your computer is set to the correct date and time. Right-click on the clock in the toolbar. This is usually in the bottom right corner. Select Adjust Date and Time. In the pop-up, make sure that you've selected the correct time and time zone or let Windows set them automatically. Then click the Sync Now button. For macOS, select the Apple menu and then System Preferences. Choose Date and Time, and then manually enter the correct date and time or let Apple detect them automatically. A good general troubleshooting tip for any error that you see in Chrome is to disable all of your browser extensions. Browser extensions can interact with your computer and websites in unexpected ways, including causing some type of interference that triggers the error SSL version interference error. Here's how to disable your extensions. Enter Chrome extensions into your browser bar and use the toggle to disable each active extension. If the error goes away after disabling all of your extensions, you can try enabling your extensions one by one to find the problematic extension. In some cases, your computer's firewall or antivirus software might be interfering with your connection in a way that triggers this error message. This is especially common with Kaspersky if you've enabled its Inspect SSL Traffic option, as this feature works by manipulating SSL certificates. Other antivirus software might have similar features. To see if this is the case, try temporarily disabling your firewall or antivirus software. If the error goes away, you know that the problem is somewhere in the software. However, leaving your firewall permanently disabled isn't a great long-term solution, so you'll want to use this knowledge to either tinker with the software settings or switch to a different tool that doesn't cause you problems. In some cases, Chrome might be configured in a way that's triggering the error SSL version interference error. To rule this out, you can try resetting Chrome to its default settings. Note, resetting Chrome to its default settings will delete all of your cookies. This means you'll need to log into all of your websites again. Here's how to reset Chrome to its default settings. Enter Chrome settings/reset into your Chrome browser address bar. Click the option to restore settings to their original defaults. In the pop-up, click the Reset Settings button to confirm. This last tip only applies if you're experiencing the ERR SSL version interference error on a website that you control. In some cases, there might be an issue with how you installed your SSL certificate or how your server is configured. For example, if your server is only configured to use TLS 1.1, this will cause the ERR SSL version interference error because Chrome no longer supports TLS 1.1 after it was deprecated in 2021. To catch potential problems, you can scan your site using the Qualys SSL Labs diagnostic tool. If it flags any major issues, you'll want to fix those and then see if it makes the error go away. Pay special attention to the TLS versions that your server supports. If your server does not support TLS 1.3 or at least TLS 1.2 at a minimum, you'll need to find a way to enable that. If you scroll down to the configuration section, you can see the specific TLS versions that your server supports. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. We offer 2 months free with any annual plan, a 30-day money-back guarantee, and unlimited free basic migrations from any host. Head over to kinsta.com/plans to get started. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.